Hey, what is up, guys? It's your pal Jose here, and welcome to the very first episode of this new series I'm gonna start making. If for some reason you've been living under a rock and you don't know what, well, two things. You don't know what a Funko Pop is, and you don't know that I like to collect these guys a lot. Well, if you don't know what a Funko Pop is or what Funko is, Funko is a company that was created in 2010. They basically started making bobbleheads, like this Groot or this Rocket Raccoon. So Funko has licensing for all kinds of like pop culture, like pop culture related characters, whether it's a movie, it's a cartoon, music, TV shows, wrestling, all kinds of things. They have licenses for a lot of things nowadays. So yeah, in the past, I think I want to say like 2-3 years, they've become like super popular. I started collecting probably, I want to say, almost 4 years ago. If you go back to our very first episodes on this channel, we had like 2 or 3 in the back. Now we have a whole bunch of them. So yeah, like I said, they started making bobbleheads, and if you can tell, if you can see, like most of their little vinyl figures have big heads, small bodies, they base this type of, I guess, toy from a Japanese toy that is, they call them chibi back in Japan, and it's basically that big head and small body. Since I buy a lot of Funkos, and I buy at least one each month, I thought, why not make a series where I unbox a Funko Pop that I got that month? Or maybe if I didn't get one a particular month, I'll unbox one of the ones that I have in the back. Most of the Funkos that I get are like stuff that I like, because they make all kinds of Funkos, and I don't like all of them. You know, there's some that I'll see at the store. I'm like, well, I mean, it looks cool, but it's not something that I like. For example, right here I have Neo from The Matrix, and The Matrix is one of my favorite movies of all time. So I bought him. I have Goku. Goku's Dragon Ball is like one of my favorite animes, if not my favorite anime. And right here I have Miss Piggy. Miss Piggy, actually, I bought her for my wife. I mean, I like Miss Piggy. I used to watch The Muppets growing up as a kid. But this one, I bought it for my wife. I just thought it was pretty cool, and she saw it and she liked it, and I got it for her. So, and I have a lot of Batmans. Batman's one of my favorite comic book characters, or, you know, superheroes. So I have a lot of Batmans. So I thought, like I said, I thought, why not make it a monthly, you know, unboxing where, you know, I get one and I unbox it. So without further ado, the very first monthly, I guess I'll call this monthly Funko Pop unboxing. I have it right here. I just got them in the mail like 2 days ago. So without further ado, let's get to it. So this month's Funko is from, oh man, I just noticed that the box is messed up. From Batman the Animated Series, which is a Batman, it's a cartoon from the 90s. Let me just tell you which Funko it is first. So today we're gonna be opening Batman Robot. And like I said, it's from Batman the Animated Series. If you don't know what Batman the Animated Series, it's a cartoon from the 90s. And it's obvious that it's a Batman cartoon. It was a Saturday morning cartoon, but one of my favorite things about this series is that it's a little bit dark. It's based off the Tim Burton, you know, Batman, like that series, that style of cartoon or movie. It's kind of dark. Even the cartoons, the cartoon itself is like really dark, not in the like dark where you know, they're killing people or whatever. It's just like the scenery, it's dark. It's actually one of the first cartoons where the actual drawings were made in black paper. So that's one of the weird things about Batman the Animated Series. So yeah, without further ado, let's get this guy out. Actually, I just finished watching the episode where he came out, and it's like, to me, it seemed like a kind of like a Twilight Zone. It could be like a Twilight Zone episode. It's kind of weird. So here he is. I'll put like a close up right now of him. Yeah, as you can see. So in the cartoon, spoilers if you haven't seen the cartoon or if you plan to watch the episode where he comes out. Basically, the episode starts where you see these guys trying to break into this warehouse and steal some. Man, what the heck is inside? What? This is the first time I ever get a Funko where you can hear something in the inside. And it's a little bit damaged from the wing, from the cape. So yeah, back to the story. It starts with some guys trying to break in into this warehouse where they have like boxes of like confiscated evidence. And one of the boxes, Batman breaks out. So you think, oh, this is the real Batman, but in reality, it's kind of like a clone. But the clone thinks he's real, like he thinks he's actual Batman. And the episode, you know, they're like short episodes, like 20 minutes at the most, 20, 30 minutes at the most. But it's really cool. I really enjoy the episode because, like I said, it was like a Twilight Zone-y kind of episode. And it's like a standalone episode. You know, it starts and it ends, and there's no continuation from it. But I really like that, his face being shown like a robot comes out in the cartoon as well. So it's a pretty, I really recommend. I think it's called, something Silicon Soul. So if you go like to Google Play, you can buy the episode like $1.99. Oh, and by the way, this is the second wave of Batman the Animated Series Funko Pop that came out. The first wave had, hold on, let me check. So yeah, like I said, this is the second wave of Batman the Animated Series Funko Pops that we get. The first wave had Batman, Robin, Batgirl, the Joker, Harley Quinn, Poison Ivy, Man-Bat, which was a San Diego Comic-Con like exclusive, and Mr. Freeze. It was also an exclusive from the Legion of Collections. It's a box that you get, and you would get it there. And the second wave has Clayface, Bane, Batman robot, and then have a Batman robot without the cowl. You can see just like the robot face, but that's a Chase variant. So if you don't know what a Chase is, Chase is like a rare Funko. So they're kind of hard to find, and you can find them like on eBay or on Amazon. Somebody that got it at the store, but they probably sell it like for $30. And it also had, second wave also has Catwoman, Scarecrow, and the Phantasm. I have the first wave, except for Man-Bat and Mr. Freeze. And this is my first Funko Pop from the wave 2. So this is Batman from the animated series, the first wave. And this is Batman Robot. They're basically the same. They just, one of the eyes is red, and then you can see the half of the robot face. And I didn't notice that even the first wave on Batman has like some damage on the cape. Like the mold wasn't done correctly or something, or there was like like something was wrong with the mold. But yeah, here you can see both of them. They're pretty cool. Both of them are pretty cool. And like I said, you can tell they were made by the same mold because the cape's going the same way. They just changed the face, the head. So, I mean, I got him for like $8 on eBay, so it's not that bad. But I don't know what's inside. I've never heard like a pop that had like something inside. So yeah, that's our first episode of our monthly Funko Pop unboxing. Like I said, this month's was Batman Robot from Batman the Animated Series, series Wave 2 from the Funko Pop collection. If you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Also, if you haven't subscribed, please hit that subscribe button already. And we'll see you guys next month with another Funko Pop unboxing. Peace.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And if you want to watch more of my videos, make sure you click the annotation on the right. So, like always, you're out, locos.